So hello friends and hello students. So you already know that we have started taking class on Zoom app, but due to some security reasons we stopped taking class on Zoom app, and now onwards I will start taking your lectures on my YouTube channel named as Engineer Naveen Gowd. So you all need to catch me on my YouTube channel, that is Engineer Naveen Gowd. You can search it on YouTube by typing ERNAVEEN Naveen Gowd, GAUR Gowd. So students, you already know that we are now discussing about the rolling contact bearing in bearing chapter. So today we will start some numerical problem on rolling contact bearing and some basic concepts of life of a bearing, how we can find out life of a bearing and rating life. So start our topic. So what is life of a bearing? So students, you already know life of a bearing means the bearing, how much time the bearing work in a machine, or we can say that the first fatigue failure showing on the bearing is the last life of a bearing. So how we can find out the life of a bearing? We can find out life of a bearing in million revolution, or we can say that in hours. We can find life of a bearing in two ways, one in million revolution or one in hours. So how we can explain it? We can explain it if we take an example that a bearing work for 500 hours. So that 500 hour is the life of a bearing. Similarly, if we can say that a bearing have the life of 1000 million revolution. So the 1000 million revolution is the life of a bearing. After 1000 revolution, the bearing may fails or break. Similarly, the bearing after 500 hours may break or fail is known as life of a bearing. So second point or second topic is rating life. So what is rating life? Rating life 100 bearings, only 90% or only 50% of bearing complete the life which is suggested by the company. So the minimum lot which complete the life is known as rating life. So I think you get the point. So life of a bearing and rating life is also find out by the formula. So I will discuss it later in during our session. So after that, design of rolling contact bearing. So bearing have three numbers, or it may be of four numbers or five numbers, but first I explain you about the three number bearing. So if we have the bearing number 305, as you seen in given example, so 305 last two digit in the right side of 305 gives you the bore diameter. So 05 multiplied by 5 gives you 25, and 25 millimeter is your bore diameter of a bearing. So one new word coming from this point, that is bore diameter. So bore diameter is the diameter of the journal or inner diameter where the shaft fix. So you already know that the bearing have two parts. One is moving part and second one is fixed part. Moving part is internal part. So the bore diameter is the diameter of internal part, where the shaft is fixed. So you get bore diameter from last two digit, that is 05 multiplied by 5 gives you 25 millimeter. And the left side digit, that is 3, gives you the series of bearing. Series of bearing. So how we can get the about the series of bearing? As you see in my notes, that extra light bearing have 100 series. Similarly, light series have 200 series, medium light series of bearing has 300 series, and heavy bearing have 400 series. This is about the load of the bearing, load on the bearing. So 305, 3 series give, that means 300 series gives you the medium load bearing. Okay, so next is our first numerical, which is on the rolling contact bearing. So I will read a statement for you, and then after it we can solve it very easily. So a single rod deep groove ball bearing is subjected to a radial force 8 kN and thrust force of 3 kN. The shaft rotates at 1200 rpm. The expected rotating life is 20,000 hours. The minimum acceptable diameter of shaft is 75 mm. Select a suitable ball bearing for this application. So what you have to find out, you have to select a suitable ball bearing for this application, which are given, you have given some data. There is radial force given, axial force given. Axial force is also known as thrust force. And we have speed of shaft given. And we have life of a bearing in hours given. That is 20,000 hours. So, and diameter of shaft is given. So, how we can solve this problem? As you know that, we have to find out the suitable ball bearing number. We have to find the bearing number for this problem. So first, to select bearing, we have to find dynamic load capacity. Agar humare ko bearing select karna hai, so we have to find out dynamic load rating. So dynamic load rating is represented by capital C. Represented by capital C. So the formula for the life of a bearing in million revolution is L is for life of a bearing is equal to C dynamic load rating and divide by F. F is again total load or resultant load on the bearing, we can say that, and multiplied by 10 to power 6. This gives the life of a bearing in million revolution. So we don't have the dynamic load rating. We don't have the resultant force. So first of all, we have to find out the dynamic force, and after that we can find out the dynamic load rating. So dear students, first of all, we find the resultant load on the bearing in this problem. So formula for resultant load in the resultant load on the bearing is X multiplied by V multiplied by FR plus Y into Fa. So this formula is also written in the data design book, which is also allowed by the universities, all the universities in their theoretical exams. So you can get this formula in your data design book. So I will explain you about the formula where X and Y are the radial and axial factors, where X is radial factor and Y is axial factor, and both the values, X and Y values, is getting by the table which is given in the data design book. So how we get the value of X? The value of X is getting by finding the ratio of FA by C naught. Finding the ratio of FA by C naught. Similarly, we get the value of Y by finding the value ratio of FA by FR. These two ratios gives you the values, and these values gives you the value of X and Y from table. So after that, you know that we have the bearing. So first of all, we assume the bearing number 6215, and for the bearing number 6215, we get the value of C naught. That means we get the value of dynamic load and dynamic load capacity C naught, that is 41385 from data book. And in the data book there are many tables from where we get these values. So after that, find out the value of FA by C naught. So FA by C naught will give you 0.07, and FA by FR will give you 0.37. From these two values, FA by C naught and FA by FR, you will get the values of X and Y from data book. So X gives you 0.56 and Y gives you 1.6 from data book. So putting these values in the resultant force or resultant load, XVFR plus YFA, and where V is 1 for inner ring is rotating. If inner ring of the bearing is rotating, we take always V is equal to 1. Okay, I think you get the point. So after that, we will get the resultant force. By putting the resultant force in the formula of life in a million revolution, you will get the value of you may get the value of dynamic load rating. But you know that you have in the data, in the given data, we have the value of life in hour. So first we find the value of life in revolution. Then after that we can find out the value of dynamic load rating. So the formula for life of a bearing in revolution we can find out by 60 into n into life in hours. So 60 into n, speed of the shaft is 1200 and multiplied by life in hour is 20,000. So by putting these values, we will get the life of a bearing in million revolution, or we can say that in revolution. So the answer is 1440 million revolution, or we can say that 1440 into 10 raised to power 6 revolution. So the value of k, which is in the formula L is equal to C by F t power k multiplied by 10 raised to power 6, k is 3 for ball bearing. The value of k is taken as 3 for ball bearing, and value of k is equal to 10 by 3 for roller bearing. So by putting these values in the given formula, we will get the value of C, dynamic load rating. So by taking the value of dynamic load rating, and we will now compare this value from the table, from the given table which is in the data design book. So for the table, the data design book, the bearing number is 6215. The value of C is equal to 50,600. So this value is not comparable with the calculated value, that is 104793. So this bearing number is not stable for this problem. So next we take other bearing number, that is 635. This is also not suitable for our problem. Lastly, we can find out the bearing number. We will take the bearing number 6415, which is suitable. And similarly, all the procedure which is followed above is same is followed by the 6415. Okay. So this is our first problem on rolling contact bearing, and I will assure you that if you watch this complete video on my channel, you may get the idea of solving rolling contact bearing problems. So now we are taking unsolved numerical problems of V.B. Bhandari book, and this is on the topic of rolling contact bearing, and basically these are on the load life relationship. These problems are on load life relationship. So dear students, this is our first unsolved numerical problem from V.B. Bhandari book. That is the problem number 15.1. A ball bearing with a dynamic load capacity of 22.8 kN is subjected to a radial load of 10 kN. Calculate first expected life in million revolution that 90% of bearing will reach. Second, life in hour if shaft rotating at 1450 rpm, and life that 50% of bearing will complete or exceed before fatigue failure. So first we have to write the given data, that is the dynamic load capacity C is equal to 22.8 kN. Secondly, the radial load is 10 kN. There is only a radial load, so we can say that radial load is equal to total load on the bearing. So FR is equal to F, that means 10 kN is equal to total load on the bearing. So you know that first we have to find out the expected life. So we have the formula for expected life, that is C by P, or we can say that C by total load on bearing, and the power of the complete C by P is small p, and small p is also written as k in other book, that is in R.S. Kurmi book. This formula may be written in different book as different. So this formula is according to the V.B. Bhandari book, or we can say that from data design book of V.B. Bhandari. So C by P, capital P, power small p, where small p is equal to 3 for ball bearing and small p is equal to 10 by 3 for rolling bearing. So we have given data C is equal to 22.8, where capital P is equal to 10 kN. As we know that there is only a radial load is given. So radial load is equal to total load on the bearing. So from the given formula, we can easily find out the value of life of a bearing in million revolution. So we get 11.852352 million revolution from the calculation, or we can say that 11.85 into 10 raised to power 6 10 raised to power 6 revolution. So million is removed by multiplying 10 raised to power 6 and it is in revolution. So this is our first value which we calculate, that is life of a bearing in revolution. Okay, after that we have to find out life of a bearing in hour. So you know that we have given data of speed of shaft, that is 1450. So life in hour is easily calculated by the given formula of life of a bearing, finding out in hour. Life of a bearing in hour is equal to, or we can say that life of a bearing in revolution is equal to 60 into n into life of a bearing in hour. L10H is life of a bearing in hour and L10 is life of a bearing in revolution. So why we represent it at L10? So L10 represents the minimum criteria of a bearing, and that means rating life. So we have to take 90% of bearing or gives you the satisfactory result, where 10% bearings make you opposite results. So put the value of life of a bearing in revolution, that is 11.85, that is equal to 60 into n is speed of a shaft, that is 1450 multiplied by life of a bearing in hour we have to find out, and then divide by 10 to power 6. 10 to power 6, why we divide by 10 to power 6? Because we have to find out the value in hour. So we have to find out the value in hour. We will get after calculation 136.2068 is the hours. This is the life of a bearing in hour. After that we have to find out, that is the third value, that means what the question is calculating. In the question, the third we have to find out life that 50% of bearing will complete. Aapko ye batana ki 50% bearing kitni life complete kar rahe hain before fatigue failure. Fatigue failure aane se pehle jo ek load hai bearing ka, unme se 50% bearing kitni life complete kar pa rahe hain. So you know that 10% of bearing will complete these number of revolution, their 11.85 into 10 raised to power 6 number of revolutions. So similarly, we will multiply, if we find out L50, we can multiply L10 by 5. We will get the 50% number of bearings alive. So multiplied 5 into L10, we will get 59.25 million revolution. So as you have get the idea of L10, L10 gives you only 10% of bearing life. L10 means the life of a bearing of 10% bearings only. So if you find out 50% bearing life, you have to multiply L10 by 5. You will get the answer. This is our first problem on V.B. Bhandari, in V.B. Bhandari book. That is unsolved numerical. Second numerical is 15.2. So in 15.2 numerical, I will write only the given data, not the statement. So you get statement from the data, you will get statement from the V.B. Bhandari book and from the unsolved numerical problem. So given data is bore diameter 40 millimeter, radial load 25 kN, coefficient of friction 0.0012, and the speed of the shaft is 1440 rpm. And power lost due to friction we have to find out. Power lost due to friction we have to find out. As you know that first of all we have find the power lost. What we have to find out? We have to find out the power lost. So the formula for power is 2 pi nt divided by 60. Or if you find out the value of power in other dimensions, we can say that in millimeter or in meter, we have to divide by the 10 to power 3 or 10 to power 3 also. because the dimensions are in millimeter. If we will find out the value in meter, we have to divide by 10 raised to power 3. Okay, the value is converted into meters. Similarly, if we find out the torque in the given problem, or we can say that for bearing or shaft, the formula for finding out torque is equal to coefficient of friction multiplied by radial load into radius of the given shaft, or radius of the bore, we can say that. So we have mu, coefficient of friction, we have radial load also, and we have radius of the bore diameter also, db by 2. That means diameter divided by 2 gives you the radius of the bore. So by putting these values, mu, fr and db by 2, we will get the torque, that is 0.090477 kilowatt. This is our torque which we have to calculate it from this given formula. So I will again explain you about how we can find out the torque for this problem. The formula for finding out torque for the shaft which is rotating in the bearing is coefficient of friction multiplied by radial load multiplied by radius of the bearing. If we don't have the value of coefficient of friction in the given problem, then we multiply radial load multiplied by radius will give you the torque. Similarly, this value gives you the power lost. By putting this value, we will get the power lost in the given system. Okay, so how much torque is generated is the power lost, because the torque is transmitted by the shaft from one place to other place. So this power is also lost, as that is the answer. Power loss due to friction in this given problem, we have to find out torque only. So this 0.090477 kilowatt is our answer. Next question is 15.3 of V.B. Bhandari book. This is also unsolved numerical. So given data is radial load 2500 newton, axial load is equal to 1000 newton. Okay, and the value of C, that means dynamic load capacity, 7350 newton. And value of x and y is also given, that is 0.6 and 1.6, and the speed of shaft is 720 rpm. We have to find out life of a bearing. So we have to find out life of bearing, but this is not given in revolution or in hour. So how we can find out these values? We can find out these values easily. First, you know that we have given radial load as well as axial load. First we have to find out the resultant load on bearing. So you know that the formula for resultant load, finding out resultant load on bearing, is XFR plus YFA. XVFR, that is XVFR. I have missing the value of V also, but you know that if the inner part is moving, the value of V is equal to 1. That's why I ignore to take the value of 1. So you know that we have given value of X as well as value of Y, and we have given the value of FR as well as value of FA. So by putting these values, we will get the resultant load, that is 3000 newton. And after you know that we have the formula for finding out the life of a bearing in million revolution, that is L10 is equal to C by P and the whole power small p. So by putting these values, that is we have given the value of dynamic load capacity C, capital C, that means 7350, and divide by capital P. Capital P is resultant load, that is 3000 newton. And the small p, because the ball, this is ball bearing. So for case of ball bearing, small p is equal to 3. And in case of roller bearing, the value of small p is 10 by 3. So we get 14.70 million revolution for life of a bearing in the given problem. If we find out the value answer in hour, put this, find the value in hour, then we have the formula for getting the answer in life in hour. L10 इज इक्वल टू 60 n l 10 h / 10^6. सो वी हैव l 10 दैट इज 14.70 मिलियन रिवोल्यूशन, 60 इंटू n इज इक्वल टू 720 वी हैव गिवन स्पीड ऑफ शाफ्ट एंड l 10 h वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट. सो देर इज ओनली वन अननोन वैल्यू दैट इज l 10 h. By calculating or putting these values, we will get 340.419560 hours. This is our third numerical problem, and after that we have the fourth numerical problem on rolling contact bearing. And this type of problem is also coming in recent theoretical exams. Recently, which is conducted recently by the university, and this type of numericals are most important. So the given statement is a ball bearing operates on following work cycle. So element number we have radial load, we have speed, and we have element timing. So the dynamic load capacity is also given, that is 16.6 kN. Calculate average speed of rotation and the equivalent radial load. And third is bearing life. We have to find out three values, that is average speed of rotation. That means if we have three number of bearing or four number of bearing, first we have to find out average speed of rotation. सेकेंड वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट इक्विवेलेंट रेडियल लोड, हमारे को इक्विवेलेंट रेडियल लोड निकालना, और थर्ड हमारे को निकालना है बेयरिंग लाइफ. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट फर्स्ट एवरेज स्पीड ऑफ रोटेशन. सो एवरेज स्पीड ऑफ रोटेशन इज फाइंडिंग बाय n1 इनटू एलिमेंट टाइम परसेंटेज. सो वी हैव एलिमेंट स्पीड, यू नो दैट वी हैव गिवन एलिमेंट स्पीड दैट इज n1 720, n2 1440 एंड n3 900. So, and we have also given element time percentage, that is 30, 50 and 20, about 720, 1400, 1400 and 900. So first we have to find out the average speed of rotation. So NA is equal to N1 into element time percentage similarly, plus N2 into element time percentage plus N3 into element time percentage. So you know that N1 is 720 multiplied by element time percentage is 30%, that is 30/100. Similarly, plus N2 is 1440 and the element time percentage is 50, and so 50/100, and N3 is equal to 300 multiplied by 20 time percentage 20/100. So we will get the average speed of bearing is 1116 rpm is the average speed. Okay, this is our first calculation or first answer which is asking in the statement. Second is equivalent dynamic loading. We have to find out equivalent dynamic load. So you know that we have number of bearings, number of shafts. So how we can find out the equivalent dynamic load? There is a new formula which is using in this rolling contact bearing, that is PE is equivalent dynamic load. It is denoted by PE is equal to cube root of N1 P1 cube plus N2 P2 cube plus N3 P3 cube divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3. So you know that N1, N2, N3 are the speed of the respective shafts. Similarly, P1, P2, P3 are the loads on the shaft, that means radial loads, that is given in the table above. So we have put these values in the given formula and we will get the answer for equivalent dynamic load. That is, the answer for the equivalent dynamic load is 6271.572765 N. Okay, so but you have to take the value of N1, N2 and N3 is, you know that the value of N1 is 720, but you don't take the value of N1 720. You have to take the value of N1, that is 720 multiplied by time percentage, that is 30/100. So you take the value of N1 is equal to 216. Similarly, you don't take the value of N2 is equal to 1440. you have to take value of n2 is equal to 1440 multiplied by time percentage, that is 50 by 100, that gives you 720 RPM. Similarly, you take n3 is equal to 900 multiplied by 20 by 100, so you will get 120 RPM. So by putting these values in equivalent dynamic load, you will get the PE. And what we have to find out, the third calculation, we have to find out the life of a bearing, average life, we can say that, for all bearings. So L10H, life in hour, is equal to, you know that we have the formula for life in hour, that is L10 is equal to 16 and L10H divided by 10 to the power 6. So from here we can get the value in revolution. If we have to find out the value in revolution, you know that we have value of dynamic load, load capacity, and we have the total force or total resultant load. So by putting these values, resultant load and dynamic load capacity, we will get the life of a bearing in million revolution, that is 18.54. And what is the value of resultant load? You know that we have P1, P2, P3. So sum of P1, P2, P3 is the resultant. Okay. So this is our three answers which are asking in this problem. So question number 15.5. So 15.5 of a rolling contact bearing from the book V.V. Bhandari. This is also the unsolved numerical. So how we can find out this or how can determine these values? So the given statement is the radial load acting on ball bearing is 2500 newton for the first 5 revolution and reduces to 1500 newton for next 10 revolution. The load variation then repeat itself. The expected life of a bearing is 20 million revolution. Determine dynamic load carrying capacity of bearing. So you have to determine dynamic load carrying capacity. That means capital C. So you know that in the statement, there is two conditions are given. One condition is that there is radial load of 2500 newton for first 5 revolution only. The radial load for first 5 revolution is 2500 newton, and for next 5 revolution it is reduced to 1500 newton. So WR1 and WR2, we can say that FR1 or FR2, that are radial load for one condition, radial load for second condition. So FR1 is 2500 newton and FR2 is 1500 newton. And we have also given the number of revolution of the shaft. So N1 is 10 revolution, for first 5 revolution. So pehle N1 is equal to first 5, N1 is equal to 5 and N2 is equal to 10. So first 5 revolutions ke liye aapka radial load 2500 hai, and for next 10 revolution there is radial load of 1500 newton. So we have write these given data. Okay, and we have also given the expected life of a bearing, that is 20 million revolution. So life of a bearing is also given, 20 million revolution. So we have these given data. We have to find out the dynamic load capacity, that means capital C. So we have the formula L10 is equal to capital C divided by capital F. Capital F is resultant load. And the whole power is equal to k and multiplied by 10 to the power 6. So you know that the value of k is for ball bearing is equal to 3, and value of for 10 by 3, value of k for 10 by k is equal to 10 by 3 for roller bearing. So first we have to find out equivalent dynamic load. You know that we have number of radial load and number of speed about 5 revolution or 10 revolution. So in the previous question we also used this formula, equivalent dynamic load. So cube root n1 p1 cube plus n2 p2 cube divided by n1 plus n2. So here there is no time percentage is given against the speed, so we directly use n1 and n2, that is the speed for 5 revolution or 10 revolution. So we don't need to multiply n1 into time percentage. So by putting these values, we will get equivalent dynamic load, that is 1953.8 Newton. Similarly, by putting equivalent dynamic load, that is C by F, F is equivalent dynamic load. Now we will put the value of F is equal to equivalent dynamic load. In previous question also, we have to put the value of F is equal to equivalent dynamic load, not any other value. So L10 is equal to C divided by F the whole power K multiplied by 10 to the power 6, and where L10 in revolution is given, that is 20 million revolution. So by putting L10 is equal to 20 is equal to C divided by 1953.8 whole power 3, we will get the value of dynamic load capacity, that is 5303.43 Newton. So students, I think you will get the point, or you will get the idea of solving these problems. But you need to get familiar with the data design book, which you are using in your theoretical exams. So this is most important, to get in touch with your data design book. If you don't get in touch with your data design book, you don't solve these problems in your exams. So you may have many problems during solution of these problems. So next question, that is our 15.6 question from V.B. Bhandari, unsolved numerical of rolling contact bearing. So dear students, a ball bearing subjected to a radial load of 3000 Newton is expected to have a satisfactory life of 10,000 hour at 720 rpm with a reliability of 95%. Then calculate dynamic load carrying capacity of bearing so that it can be selected from manufacturing catalog based on 90% reliability. If there are four such bearing, each with a reliability of 95% in system, what is the reliability of complete system? So you have to find out the reliability of complete system.
Sorry, due to some disturbance, I will again start.
So there is radial load is also given, that is 3000 Newton. There is life in hour is given, that is 10,000 hour. And after that, we have given the speed of the shaft, that is 720 rpm. So, and that one condition is also given, that 95% of bearing, 95% of bearing have the life of 10,000 hour. This is given, okay. There is life of 10% of bearing in hour is equal to 10,000 hour, and life of 95% of bearing in hour is equal to also 10,000 hour. Or we can say that the 10,000 hours life is given for 95%, not for 10%. Okay, this may be clarified in a later statement. Okay. So we have to find out dynamic load capacity, C. That means we have to find out capital C. So we have the formula, L10 is equal to capital C divided by capital F the whole power K multiplied by 10 to the power 6. That gives you the million revolution life of a bearing. So you know that, students, we will get the value of dynamic load capacity from this formula, that is C. So first of all, we have to find out the load life relationship. We have the new formula, that is L divided by L10 is equal to log normal 1 by R divided by log normal 1 by R90 and the whole power 1 by B, where B is constant. The value of B is equal to 1.17 from data design book. So students, R is reliability. We use R is for reliability. So you know that L is for life of a bearing, and where L10 is used for life of a bearing for 90% of bearings, and upper L gives you the given data, that is for 95%. So we use L95 above and we use L90 for below. So by putting these values, L95 divided by L10, we can say that, or we can say that L90, because we can find out the values comparison with 90% of bearing. Okay, so L95 divided by L90, this is written as L10. So L95 divided by L90 equal to log normal 1 by आर 95 सिमिलरली डिवाइड बाई लॉग नॉर्मल 1 डिवाइड बाई आर 90, वेयर आर इज फॉर रिलायबिलिटी ऑफ बियरिंग. दैट मीन्स आर 95 मीन्स रिलायबिलिटी ऑफ बियरिंग इज 95%. सिमिलरली आर 90 इज रिलायबिलिटी ऑफ बियरिंग इज 90%. एंड द होल पावर इज 1/1.17. 1.17 इज वैल्यू ऑफ बी. सो वी हैव गिवन द वैल्यू ऑफ एल 95 इज 10,000 आवर एंड वेयर द वैल्यू ऑफ एल 90, और वी कैन से दैट वी डोंट हैव द वैल्यू ऑफ एल 90, सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट दिस वैल्यू. सो बाय पुटिंग दीज वैल्यूज वी विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ लाइफ ऑफ अ बियरिंग इन मिलियन रिवोल्यूशन, दैट इज 799.24. ओके, एंड बाय पुटिंग दिस वैल्यू दिस कैलकुलेटेड वैल्यू ऑफ लाइफ इन द अबोव फॉर्मूला वी विल गेट द आंसर ऑफ डायनेमिक लोड कैपेसिटी, दैट इज 27840.72 न्यूटन. सो दिस इज आवर फर्स्ट कैलकुलेशन विच इज आस्किंग इन द क्वेश्चन. We have to find out system reliability for system reliability for complete system. Okay, so we have the formula for system reliability. System reliability, the whole system reliability is finding by RS is equal to reliability the whole power n, where n is number of bearing in the system. So you know that there are four number of bearing, and this is given in the statement. So RS is equal to R the power n. So we have given 95% of reliability in the statement. So 0.95 the whole power 4 gives you the system reliability. That is 0.8145. So in percentage 81.45 reliable. The whole system is 81.45% reliable, where RS is reliability of complete system. So students, you will get the complete idea of solving this type of numerical problems. So this is our seventh problem for solving rolling contact bearing in VB Bhandari, and that is 15.7 numerical problem. A system involves four identical ball bearings, each subjected to radial load of 2500 newton. The reliability of system, that is one out of four bearing fails during the lifetime of 5 million revolution, is 82%. So the reliability of one bearing is 82%. Determine dynamic load carrying capacity for bearing so as to select it from manufacturing catalog based on 90% reliability. Okay, so we have some given data, that is number of bearing is equal to 4, capital N is equal to 4. We have radial load, that is equal to resultant load. There is only a single load is given, that is radial load. So the radial load is equal to total load on bearing, that is 2500 newton. And we have also given the life of a bearing, that is 5 million revolution. Okay, we have given these values. Okay, that I will again read the statement for you. A system involves four identical ball bearing, each subjected to a radial load of 2500 newton. The reliability of system, that is one out of four bearing fail during the lifetime of 5 million revolution. Lifetime, that means lifetime is given 5 million revolution, is 82%. So that is reliability of a system, the reliability of a system. Okay, RS is given, not for single bearing. So RS is equal to 82% and life of a bearing in million revolution is 5. So we have formula L10 is equal to C divided by capital F the whole power K multiplied by 10 raised to power 6 revolution, where you know that K is equal to 3/4 ball bearing and 10 raised to power 10 by 3/4 roller bearing. Okay, and you know that the load life relationship L by L10 is equal to log normal 1 by R divided by log normal 1 by R 90 the whole power 1 by B. So you know that the life of a bearing is given in million revolution, that is 5 divided by L10 is equal to L10, L that means log normal 1 by 0.95, similarly log normal 1 by 0.90, and the whole power is 1 by 1.17. okay, so from here we can easily find out the life, that is L10 9.5176470 million revolution, where B is equal to 1.17 from data book. And you know that we have the given the system reliability, that is 82%, or we can write it as 0.82 is equal to the reliability the whole power 4. So from here we can easily find out the reliability of individual bearing. So R gives you 95%. So individual bearing have 95% reliability. Okay, so dear students, after that we can easily find out the dynamic load capacity from the given formula, that is L10 the whole power 1 by k multiplied by the total load. Okay, we will get the capital C, 5298.05 newton. So I think you get the idea of solving these numerical problems. So you need to practice more and more numericals of rolling contact bearing from the books which you have, that is R.S. Khurme from V.V. Bhandari or any other book. Okay, so after that there is one more problem. This is also most important numerical problem from R.S. Khurme book or maybe in any other book. Okay, so this type of problem may be also chance to come in your theoretical exams. So select a single rod deep groove ball bearing with following operating cycles with a life of 15,000 hours. So there is a table is given. In the first column there is fraction of cycle given. In second column type of load is given. In third column radial load is given. And in fourth column thrust load is given. Next column speed is given, and last column service factor is given. So dear students, what we have to do, assume radial and axial load factor to be 1.0 and 1.5. so x and y, value of x and y is also given, where radial load factor is x, which is 1.0, and axial load factor is 1.5. and inner race rotates. You know that if inner race rotates, the value of v is equal to 1. Okay, so first of all we have to find out the resultant load, that is F is equal to XVR plus YFA multiplied by service factor. If the value of service factor is not given, we don't take this value KS. So the formula for the resultant load, if the service factor is not given, XVFR plus YFA. If service factor is given, we can consider it KS. So similarly we have to find out F1, F2, F3, F4. Because you know that we have given FR1, FR2, FR3, FR4 and FA1, FA2, FA3, FA4. So that we can easily find out resultant load for different bearing. For bearing number 1, for bearing number 2, bearing number 3, bearing number 4. So we will get 4 values, F1, F2, F3 and F4 from the above formula. Okay, after that we have to find out the resultant load. So now the formula for resultant load is equal to L1 F1 the power k plus L2 F2 the power k plus L3 F3 the power k plus L4 F4 the power k divided by L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus F4. Divided by L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus F4 and the whole in brackets. Okay. So dear students, first of all, you know that these values are given. Okay, but we don't have the value of life, that is L1, L2, L3, L4. So first of all, we have to find out the life. So rating life in revolution, that is L is equal to 60 N into LH. So you know that the life in hour is given, 60 multiplied by N, N is also given, and L is not, N is not given in this case. 60 into N into 15,000, that is life in hour. So we will get 0.9 into 10 to the power 6 N revolution. Okay, so after that you know that life of a bearing for 1 by 10 cycle, okay, fraction of cycle is given in the table. So life of a bearing for one number bearing is L1 is equal to 1 by 10, that is friction is given in the table. 1 by 10 is friction multiplied by 0.9 into 10 to the power 6, and you know that the speed of different bearing are different, so multiplied by n1 for first. Similarly, L2 is equal to 1 by 10 into 0.9 into 10 to the power 6 into N2. Next is multiplied by N3 and next is multiplied by N4. So from these values we can get the L1, L2, L3 and N4. Okay. And by putting these values in the above formula, that is, you know that F1 N1, F2 N2, F3 N3, F4 N4 divided by L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L4, we will get the resultant force or resultant load. After that, you know that how we can find out total life of the system. L is equal to L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L4. We will get the total life. Dynamic load rating C is equal to F into L by 10 to the power 6 and the power 1 by K. From here, we will easily get the value of dynamic load rating, that is 49193N. And by comparing this value from table, we will get the bearing number, that is 6215. So students, you will get the idea of this complete problem of rolling contact bearing. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the pivot and collar bearing. So thank you for watching this video, and I will request you to share this these numerical problems with the students who need these problems to solve or for their theoretical exams. So in the coming session, we will discuss about the pivot bearing and the collar bearing. So thank you all.